I can never fail. It's impossible. I cannot be poor. I just can't. If you had heard some of these things 5 years ago, don't worry. You still got time. At least you're hearing it now. You can do something with it now. Hallelujah. You still can. It's not too late. The problem is not the capital. All the capital you need is inside you, brother. You think you need some multinationals to send you money to try to get you up? No, that's not what you need. Everything you need is inside you. I found that out a long time ago. When you take an orange seed and you put it in your hand, you don't have to do anything to that seed for it to have roots, for it to have its stem, for it to have its branches, its leaves, and to produce other fruits with many, many seeds in them. You don't have to do anything but sow that little seed in the right place, in the soil. That's all you have to do. You don't have to add anything to it. Every potential that it requires to produce everything it's got to produce is inside that seed. Everything you need to become the you that God has brought you into this world to be is inside you. Hold yourself responsible. You say, okay, for example now, I was fired at work 2 years ago. I didn't know I would be fired. I did everything I could do. I did everything that was right in that company. And then they still fired me. How could I be responsible? Yes. You are now responsible for what is happening to you now. The confusion you are in now is now the trouble. It's not the problem. Hear me. It's not what meets you that is the problem. It's what you do with what meets you in the face. Hey, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. In other words, it's not your experience that is the problem. It's what you do with your experience. All right, you've been fired. What do you do? Where do you go from here? Do you look upward or do you look downwards? Now you've been fired. Do you think it's all over? Are you going to move better? Are you going to get greater? It's up to you. Where you go from here is what matters. Are you going to go home and have people come to you and, oh, we're so sorry. We never knew it was going to happen. We feel so terrible about it. We feel so bad. Well, never that. Are they going to be talking to you as they're trying to help you and sympathize with you? Is that what you want? The Bible says, after Lot was separated from Abraham, God spoke to Abraham. And Lot had taken the best part of the field and left the bad one for Abraham. But after he was separated from him, God spoke to him. He said, Abraham, now look to the north and to the south, to the east and the west. As far as your eyes can see, I've given it to you. Are you going to think like Abraham? Are you going to go back and say, where do I start from? I worked for this company 45 years. Where am I going to start from? What is all this? I can't understand it. Such is life. Look at me now. I'm going down. You're seeing yourself going down, and down you will go. You say, that guy's boasting. No, I'm boasting in God's word. I found out God's word works. And I've gotten a hold of it. I found out it works. It works. Glory to God, it works! The Bible says the Word of God is living and active. The Logos of God, God's revelation from the Word, it says it's living and active. If you put it inside you, it'll make you a master over circumstances of life. You will never live in fear anymore. You will not be in defeat anymore. Problem with men is they don't know how to work the Word of God. Put it inside you. There's no telling how far you'd go. All the limitations will be taken off of your life. Your potentialities will be let loose on planet Earth.